Hey guys, Sherry from The Watering Mouth here. Have a what I eat in a day to lose weight video for you today. This is three meals that follow the Eat to Live Nutritarian Lifestyle by Dr. Joel Fuhrman from his book, Eat to Live. That's what my channel is all about. If you like this kind of stuff, stick around. If you want to get the recipes for this day's worth of meals, three meals, you can just sign up at thewateringmouth.com/cheat sheet. Sign up there. And then you can also get all the old cheat sheets as well for previous videos that I've done. And of course, there's another 21-day challenge coming up. Make sure you sign up at thewateringmouth.com/challenge. There's gonna be 21 days worth of new recipes, new Eat to Live Nutritarian recipes, grocery lists, meal plans, prep instructions, so much more information. Everyone's gonna be joining in. There's hundreds of people that do this every time, so sign up. Make sure you get in on that one. And don't worry if you miss the next one that's coming up, there's gonna be another one coming up soon. So make sure you sign up, thewateringmouth.com/challenge. If you notice right behind me, I have this is some ice cream. This is what my daughter calls ice cream and she goes, okay, so make sure you sign up for the cheat sheets and let me show you how we're gonna make our meals today. All right, the first recipe that we're having today is maple blue mango soaked oats, you guys. Oh my gosh, so good. All right, what I'm starting out with is, I'm actually making enough for two days. So I'm gonna take these two mason jars here. I'm putting in some frozen banana and frozen mango, and I'm gonna go ahead and microwave these for a couple minutes to soften them up. I love the way microwaving frozen banana gets them all super mushy, because then when you mix it in, it's like using sugar or something like that. You get the sweetness mixed all throughout, and you get some nice banana flavor if you like bananas as well. And the same with the mango gets a little bit mushy, so then it's easy to sort of mix together and have bites of it here and there. If you don't like to use microwaves, no problem. You can just cook this over the stove instead, or just warm it up or thaw out the banana, or just use fresh. So into the jar, we have our banana and mango. We're gonna add the oats. I always start with about 1/3 cup of raw oats if we're gonna do raw for a recipe. Totally okay to have just soaked oats. You don't even have to cook them. So we're gonna use our oats. We're gonna put in some non-dairy milk, unsweetened, 1 tablespoon of chia, 1 tablespoon of ground flaxseed. We're gonna mix all that up. And you can just kind of eyeball the amount of milk that you use. I just add a little bit more to make sure that it's gonna, because it's gonna soak up a lot of that liquid, so you wanna make sure you have extra milk than you think you need. Add a little bit of maple extract. This is kind of the secret ingredient here that's gonna give it that really nice kind of fall-ish taste. And then you're gonna add blueberries. So you can mix all this up, or you can add the fruit at the end. It really is up to you. I don't mind just doing it all together. Then that way the next morning it's all ready to go. The next morning you can either just put it into a bowl, warm it up and eat it that way, or you can just eat it cold. Totally doesn't matter, however you want it. Okay, breakfast is done. And you've got it done for 2 days now, so score. Okay, on to lunch. So I made up this recipe for you. Edamame and corn hummus spread. It's not really hummus. Like, it's not really fair to call it hummus, I think, but I'm just gonna call it like hummus spread, okay? So we're gonna use this in wraps, but you can also use this spread as on any other kind of sandwich, or you can even use it sort of as a salad dressing too. So it's just this kind of spread that we're gonna make a lot of it, and then you can keep it on hand. So what I'm doing is taking some frozen edamame and frozen corn, and then I actually keep my garlic cloves in the freezer as well, because I don't use them up fast enough to be able to just have them out fresh, because then they go bad. So I'm just gonna take some from there and put them into a bowl, put everything in a bowl, add a little bit of water, and we're gonna end up using this water to mix as well when we go to use the food processor. So don't use too much. You don't want it like kind of floating around in there. You just wanna have a little bit to warm it up. So use the microwave to cook this. I cooked it for about 4 minutes. You can feel free to boil this in a pot over the stove if you don't use microwaves, okay? Then once you have cooked your mixture there, put this into a food processor. If you don't have a food processor, I believe you can use a blender. I didn't use my blender, but I think you actually could. So use your blender maybe, or the food processor, and then add some tahini, add some lemon juice. This is just fresh lemon juice, and then add a little bit of nutritional yeast, and that is it, you guys. This is so surprisingly delicious, and it's got some really amazing nutrition in it too. So we're gonna turn this into a wrap for lunch. So I keep my Ezekiel tortillas, these are the wraps that I like the most because they have actual whole grains in them, in the freezer. It's the type of food that I don't like to keep around in eye line a lot because it's basically a food that kind of triggers my wanting to eat grains a little bit. So I usually keep these in the freezer. And I just don't use them as much as I would say a regular tortilla because I don't like them as much as, say, flour tortillas. So I just kind of keep them there because I don't use them much. So as you can see, I separated out these tortillas before I froze them and put parchment paper in between them so they wouldn't stick together. And then I refroze them. So they're just easier to pull apart when I want to take one. So I take this, I microwave it for just a few seconds. And then you can actually, like, if you don't use the microwave, of course, you can just let it sit out or put it into a pan and heat it up for a few minutes just so it's pliable again. So you're gonna add some of the hummus spread on there. Then you're gonna add some of your mixed greens. Any kind of greens that you want will work here. Arugula would be delicious. Just some romaine or mixed greens, whatever you've got. Then you can chop up some cucumber and just throw that in there. I'm adding some red pepper as well. And what I really love about those is they give a really nice crunch. Okay, look at this, you guys. Look at this salsa I just found at Whole Foods the other day. It is pretty fairly low sodium, and it's by the Muir Glen brand. The only brand that I was able to use before was the Green Mountain Gringo. That's the only one I could find because it has 80 milligrams of sodium per serving. Typical salsas usually have like around 180 milligrams of sodium, so that was actually pretty low sodium. But this one I found has only 100 milligrams, so that's a pretty good amount, and it's just nice to be able to try a different type of salsa. So this is actually the organic Muir Glen brand salsa, and so I'm trying this one out, and I gotta say I really loved it. So add some salsa on there, close it up. Not easy to close up. This isn't like your typical burrito or whatever, but you just eat it like this, and you guys, score number two. This is super, super good and very filling. Okay, on to dinner. So we had a lot of grains today, and we had some starches in the corn. So we're just gonna keep dinner very, very simple and small. We're gonna have a small, simple mixed salad for dinner. So I wanna show you just how easy this can be to make a salad. This literally takes 4 minutes to throw a salad together, okay? So I'm taking some mixed greens out of the tub here. I'm gonna put enough in my bowl to kind of give me a good full bowl look, but I'm gonna break it up a little bit more so it's smaller, because I hate eating huge like pieces of lettuce or even baby lettuce. It's annoying to eat like that. So I'm just gonna break it up with my hands a bit. Then I'm gonna add some of that same red pepper and cucumber that I used on the wrap earlier in the day. And if you had already chopped it up, this would be great. Like, you could just throw it into your salad and not have to do anything. It would already be prepped for you. Then I'm gonna add some green onion, and just check out how I chop this green onion, you guys. Notice that my knife kind of rocks on the cutting board. This is something I've always wanted to point out. This is how you get through things with kind of a little bit of a tougher skin. Like, green onions can tend to have a little bit of a tougher skin, especially tomatoes or red pepper, like bell peppers, things like that, have a little bit tougher skin. And really anything else that you're chopping, this rocking motion I think is so, so useful to get through skins of stuff, and I think it makes it a lot easier to chop things. If I had some cooked mushrooms on hand, which I just don't, but if I did, I would be putting those on this salad as well. So I missed my mushrooms in the G-bombs today, but that's totally okay. You know, nobody's perfect. Then I'm gonna add some carrots. For the dressing on this salad, I'm gonna use simple avocado and lemon. So I'm gonna use a third of an avocado, and I have to mention that this avocado is not ripe at all, okay? So just bear with me, pretend this is ripe. What I would be doing is chopping this out, just chopping a third of this, then I would be using the fork to mash it up before I put it onto the salad. So I'd scoop it out of the skin and then put it on the salad and then mix it up so it would get really nice and mixed up in the leaves and everything and create like a nice kind of saucy thing. Adding the lemon juice right on top as well. I'm not actually adding the dressing to this one just because I want to have it dry so I can eat it tomorrow. But if I was making this for real and I had an actual ripe avocado, that's what I would be doing, okay? All right, that's it for dinner. And check out how easy it was to make a bunch of chickpeas, a whole pound of chickpeas, in my Instant Pot in the background without having to do anything. All I have to do is cool these off, rinse them, and then put some of them in the freezer, so I'll have beans for weeks. I'm gonna put a link to the Instant Pot that I have in the cheat sheets and down below this video. And you guys should seriously consider getting one too. Okay, how'd you like those? They were so easy, I gotta tell you, so, so easy. I actually made up that edamame corn hummus dip recipe on the spot while I was filming it, and you guys, so good. Really, really, you should try it. You can also use that like even as a salad dressing. That would work really well. You can use it as a spread for like a pita or a wrap like those, like I showed you, or a sandwich, something like that. Super, super yum. Hope you love it. Overnight oats can't be any simpler. Hope you love those too. I thought it was super, super delicious. And just have ripe avocados when you go to make that salad. Of course, you can replace it with tahini or something. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you liked it. If you like these free
recipes I'm always giving you, make sure you check out the upcoming 21-day Eat to Live challenge that I put on for my audience. 3 weeks, recipes, grocery lists, super, super awesome because everyone's doing it all together, so you get that kind of like group feeling. Sign up at thewatermouth.com/challenge. There's one coming up really soon, but if it's already passed, don't worry. We're gonna be doing lots more of them. We do them on a regular basis to keep everyone on track, get to your healthy weight loss goals, eat really healthy food, stick with a nutritarian diet. I promise you'll love it. Also, if you love these videos, please, if you don't know of any other way to support me, please check me out on Patreon, patreon.com/thewateringmouth. This is the place where I give some great exclusive content to my patrons, some of my personal stuff that's going on, as well as some in-depth coaching notes and all that. Check me out on there and you can support me a little bit every month to help keep making these videos for you. Just imagine it like a tip jar every month. All right, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Make sure you sign up for the challenge and have a great day. Bye!